Yes, people like to meme on windows and blue screens, but when something goes extremely wrong to the point where you actually need to see a blue screen, Windows does a really good job at telling you something went wrong. Now, we've talked about things like systemd bsod and DRM panic in the past, which basically are necessary in modern Linux, because if you have a kernel panic when you're in a desktop environment, which, unless you're talking about Linux on a server, is how you're going to be using it, you don't see when something goes wrong. It just stops. That's a problem. But today, I don't want to talk about that. Instead, I want to talk about GPU hangs. Not the physical kind of hanging where the GPU is sagging. If that is happening, please, for the love of God, fix it. Do not let that happen. Instead, I want to talk about the software kind, where something goes wrong and the GPU freezes. Ideally, what you'd like to have happen is when the GPU freezes, the user is informed in some way. Even better, they are provided a means to recover from the situation. As it stands, though, that's not really a thing that happens. But that doesn't mean that it can't happen. Set to be introduced in kernel 6.15, introduce device wedged event by Raj Jadav, I think, from Intel. Introduce device wedged event, which notifies user space of wedged, hanged, slash unstable state of the DRM device through a U event. DRM in this context not being digital rights management, it being direct rendering manager, basically graphics. This is useful, especially in cases where the device is no longer operating as expected and has become unrecoverable from driver context. Purpose of this implementation is to provide drivers a generic way to recover with the help of user space intervention without taking any drastic measures in the driver. A wedged device is basically a dead device that needs attention. The U event is the notification that is sent to user space along with a hint about what could possibly be attempted to recover the device and bring it back to a usable state. Different drivers may have different ideas of a wedged device depending on their hardware implementation and hence the vendor agnostic nature of the event. It is up to the drivers to decide when they see the need for device recovery and how they want to recover from the available methods. Now, initially, as most things tend to be in the FOSS world, this is initially being hooked up for use with Intel and AMD GPUs. NVIDIA, well, they'll do the NVIDIA thing, but this is a very generic way of approaching it, and the way that Intel or AMD is going to handle it is going to be entirely dependent on their specific GPU implementations and also what user space support exists to make use of this. From the Pharonix article on this, recovery methods could include unbinding and rebinding the kernel driver, unbinding and rebinding the driver with resetting the bus device after the driver unbind, and other steps and or no action. This is useful for situations where the kernel driver itself can't address the problematic GPU hardware state on its own due to being unable to unload slash reload the driver itself or needing to take other steps to correct the hardware state. Back to the post. Although basic recovery is possible with a simple script, admin slash users can define custom policies around recovery action. For example, if the driver supports multiple recovery methods, consumers can opt for the suitable one based on policy definition. Consumers can also choose to have the device available for debugging or additional data collection before attempting recovery. So if you're in the case of you're trying to improve the driver, you don't just want to recover from the situation, you want to know why it went wrong so you can fix the problem. But if you're an average user, that's not something you really care about. I guess in a sense it is if you're reporting a bug, but if your plan is just go about the rest of your day, well, that's not very useful to you. But all of this is stuff that takes place on the kernel side, and you as the user aren't just raw dogging the kernel. You use some sort of graphical environment to make things easy to interact with. And over in KDE land, something fun is being worked on. Experiments for GPU recovery and renderer changes by Xaver Hugel. This implements support for switching the renderer for Wayland sessions at runtime without a fallback path for GPU using clients, and uses that to attempt to give the user back an at least somewhat usable system when a severe GPU reset happens. This is obviously based on that work up in the kernel. This is a draft because not all of this is pretty yet, and ideally, this should try to recover the GPU instead of just falling back to software rendering forever, or at least it should allow surviving a GPU rebind when some other components tells the driver to recover the GPU that way. Basically, if something goes wrong, it's gonna try to fall back to software rendering and hopefully give you a usable system, and then in the long run, the real goal here is when the GPU is ready to be used again, switch back to the GPU. But even if it's just going to software rendering when something goes wrong, that's still a lot better than nothing, because then the user can go and try to recover it themselves, or most likely just restart the system, and then, you know, turning it off and on again usually fixes the problem. Now, the kernel patch that we looked at is version 11. In a slightly older version, back in version 10, Xaver left this comment. Hi, I experimented with using this in Kwin that links to the merge request we looked at before, which makes it fall back to the software renderer when a rebind is required to recover the GPU. Making it also survive the rebind properly is more challenging. The current version of the merge request doesn't do it for you and just crashes if you do it with a UDEV rule or manually, but it's doable and not a problem of the API. I'd really like to have the PID of the client that triggered the GPU reset so that we can kill it if multiple resets are triggered in a row, or switch to software rendering if it's Kwin itself and show a user-friendly notification about why the apps crashed, but that can be added later. So if you have a problematic application where if it runs, you do a reset, the GPU crashes. It runs, GPU crashes, GPU crashes, GPU crashes. Obviously, you don't want to have that process running because you're never going to get out of this cycle. So knowing which PID is doing it so you can get rid of it, at least temporarily, very good addition. Say you're playing a game like Monster Hunter Wilds, which I know for a fact was doing this during the beta. I don't know if there is a fix for that yet. And I've seen what seems to be a similar problem in Marvel Rivals. So yeah, being able to get rid of the application when a problem like that happens, very much appreciated. In relation to that comment, we have another patch set, this from Andre Almeida of Igalia, create an app info option for wedge events, directly mentioning Xaver's comment. When a device gets wedged, it might be caused by a guilty application. For user space, knowing which app was the cause can be useful for some situations, like for implementing a policy, logs, or for giving a chance for the compositor to let the user know what app caused the problem. This is an optional argument. When PID equals -1, there's no information about the app that caused the problem, or if any app was involved during the hang. Sometimes just the PID isn't enough, given the app might already be dead by the time that user space will try to check what this PID's name is. So to make life easier, also notify what's the app name in the user event. This is one of those additions to Linux which you never want to have to interact with. Just like, you know, the BSOD stuff, where you don't want your system to crash so hard you need to see a BSOD or a BSOD-like screen. However, software isn't perfect, hardware isn't perfect, and sometimes people do dumb things, whether that be at the driver level, at the software level, and, you know, bugs exist, and you want there to be a method to recover from these bugs, and preferably know what caused it. Even better, know a way to recover from the problem. All of this is a good thing for the user that you never want to deal with, and I hope that you never have to do so either. So let me know your thoughts down below. Are you happy that a change like this is coming into place? Do you think there's maybe a different way it could be handled? Do you even care? I would love to know. So if you like the video, go like the video. If you really like the video and you want to become one of these amazing people over here, check out the Patreon, subscribe, Silly Bear, pay link in the description down below. That's gonna be it for me, and may your GPU never crash. But if it does, Hopefully you can recover. Like this.